Hi, I'm Carolyn Carter. I am the Certification Tools Product Manager at Fluke Networks, and it's my pleasure today to introduce you to the FI-3000 Fiber Inspector Probe. Now we're going to actually show you how to set it up, but you'll notice I no longer have a 32 fiber display. I've moved to a 2x12 or 24 fibers. But let's go ahead and set it up. I go up here to the menu button and press that. It brings me to a number of features. So I can set up my current project, I can manage projects, which I'll show you in a different video. I can go into settings and do things like my power downtime. There's an about to go and see like what versions of software I'm using both in the probe and on the device. Today we're going to start in the current project. Let's go look at current project. Here I can change the project name, so if I wanted to call it, you know, Carolyn's MPO test, I could do that. I could put my operator name down, Carolyn. The most important thing though is your test limit. What do you want to do the pass fail against? So we're going to be using the IEC limits, and you can see you have multiple choices. You have multi-mode, you have some single fiber limits here for single mode APC, which is what we're going to be using for MPO, and document only. So if you just want to document it and don't want to do pass fail, you can choose document only. But today I'm using a multi-mode fiber, so I'm going to choose the IEC multi-mode limits. Next, this one's really fun. I need to tell the probe what type of interface I'm using. And so you can see I already had set it up by 2x12, but what are the other choices I have? I have a lot, anywhere from a 1x8 to a 1x12, and there are multiple different selections for 1x12. Do I want to test all 12 fibers? Do I want to test only 10 where the outside two are ignored or dead? Do I want to test the inner eight? Or do I want to test 8 where I'm only testing the first 4 and the last 4 and the center 4 are dead? So you can choose one way, any of those ways for 1x12s. Or I have a 1x16. I have two options for a 2x12, testing all 24 or only the center 10 on each row. And then I also have a couple selections for a 2x16 where I'm using a 2x12 and testing the 8 inner and the 8 outer. Or I have a 2x16 where I'm going to do all 32 fibers. But today we're going to go ahead and stay on the 2x12 where I'm using all 24. So you go ahead and choose the one you want, press select. So now that we've selected the fiber end type, we can also now change our cable ID set. I've already set it up to be testing between cable 001 to cable 999. If I wanted to, I could add something like a building number, a rack number, whatever I want. But most important, and I know this because I've done it a couple times, make sure you save it, because if you just hit the back button, then all the changes you just made are not going to be saved and it's going to drive you nuts. So make sure you say save. Once I've saved a new project, I can go back out to my regular real-time mode. Again, I am real-time. And in this case, just press test. We're going to start by auto-focusing both cameras. And once it does an auto-focus, it will then start doing the testing. So it is still auto-focusing. And now we're doing the test. And you can see it's receiving the results, and now it's receiving the overview to give me all the information I can see. Here's my final summary. You can see this cable actually failed, and I know that because it's nice and red and it says failed. And also, if you look at the camera itself, you can see there's now a red light. So if I don't have an iOS device or an Android device of any sort, I don't need it. I can see it completely by the camera itself. If it did pass, there'd be a green light instead of a red light. So that's really nice for some really quick testing in a data center or wherever you are. But now from the summary screen, it's really easy for me to drill in and get more information. I can see that 13 of my 24 fibers did pass and 11 failed, and I have color coding right here, so I get a really quick look. If I want to see some details, no problem. Just click the connector and it drills in. Here down below is a little slider. As I move my fiber back and forth, my slider moves also. I can now also drill in and out and see some more details. As you can see, quite a few of these fibers did fail, as I can tell by all the red up here. But let's drill in on a couple of them. Let's look at list number 3 here. I can see a lot of contaminations. What does it look like if I drill in? there's all the contamination that you can see. As you can see here, it says fiber 3 of 24. If I move to the left, I can see fiber 2, and it passed. And there's 3. There's 4, which also had some problems. So if I want, I can scroll down, but I might get confused of where I am. So if I hit this little button, View All, it takes me back to this view where I have the slider. And so I can easily see things really, really quickly. Another thing I can do from this screen is I can share. So if I want to share these results, I can share an in-face, or I can share a PDF report of the full results. And so in this case, I want to do an in-face. I could just select what do I want to share, a defect, time and date, fiber numbers, let's say just the defect overlay. And now it comes up and it lets me pick any of the different things I want to pick. So I can do that, or I can just save the image. In this case, let's go ahead and save this image to my phone. Or I could send it to my friend down below, either way. I also can save. That's really important. So in this case, I'm going to save the result as cable 02 to my project called New Project. So let's go ahead and save that. Gives me a little icon down below that it's saved. If I wanted to, I can delete, or I can press this live button to go all the way back to live view mode. So it gives me a lot of information for me to see really quickly. And that is how you make a test with the FI-3000.